Hello everyone, my name is Mengs and I welcome you guys to part 6 of Let's Play Civilization 5, A Brave New World, playing as Shaka of the Zulu Kingdom. Let us continue our journey. Alright, so in the last episode we settled a new city. Look, it's Nobama! No, we can't. And we also managed to sign a peace treaty with Sweden and Japan. Sweden and Japan, yes. Japan has musketmen. That is worrisome. We are still, I think, behind on tech. I think, yeah, we're number 6. We researched 35%, and Carthage is up to 52%. That is actually super scary. So we have to catch up in a big way. Hopefully we're not going to go to war with Carthage for a very long time. The plan is probably to take Japan. They are a bitch to fight against, though. But I think what I want to do right now is I want to settle a new city down here. Because this city is a little bit too good to ignore. And I fear that Sweden is going to snatch it away from me if I leave it for too long. I just need to deal with this barbarian encampment. And we should be able to be fine. Gustavus Adolphus has declared war on Kathmandu. That's not good. That means he's probably going to take the city for himself. Which means that maybe Sweden is going to be my next target then. They would certainly be a lot easier to face than Japan, that's for sure. Because their Bushido makes them practically invincible. Let's see, I'm building a... what am I building in Alunde? I'm building a watermill. After that, I think I'm going to queue up a settler. That's perfect, because it's going to grow to pop 10 in 2 days. So the timing actually couldn't be better. I'm currently focusing a lot on growing Alundi at the moment. And that's a little bit scary because my happiness is not looking great. And I do plan to settle yet another city. So I need to get over to industrialization really quick. And I need to make sure I get a get some factories running so that I can get my ideology. By the looks of it, I am not going to be one of the first people to adopt an ideology. That's for sure. So, it also looks like Japan just settled a new city. Come to think of it, I might go after Japan. Because their cities are so close to mine. So we'll have to see what I end up doing. This will definitely be a very aggressive game, but right now I simply have to focus everything I have on science. Because I am so far behind in that regard. Luckily my gold income is very good. But I definitely need to work on my science in a very major way. I think I'm actually going to buy myself another university. He wants open borders. No. Does he want to sell open borders for pearls? I very much doubt it. I can try. 4 gold? 5 gold? 6 gold? You see, I actually need pearls. There we go. Yeah, 2 gold per turn, that's what Open Borders is worth. But that's gonna give me We Love the King Day in some of my cities, because I know that that some of my cities wants pearls. So that is actually pretty decent. But yeah. I do believe I should be able to afford a university really soon. There we go. Kill these archers. And then move for the barbarian encampments. Alright, what should we go for right here? I do believe we have many improvements that we need right now. Alundi, on the other hand, might actually need some new improvements fairly soon. So I'm going to go down here. Oda Nobunaga has declared war on Genghis Khan. You know, Gustav Adolphus and Nobunaga, they're kind of like war buddies, I feel. They seem to declare war at the same people a lot of the time. Nobunaga is actually highest up on the scoreboard. He's going to be a total bitch to deal with later on. He has galley asses, he has crossbowmen and musketmen. I definitely wouldn't like it if he decided to attack me now. Alright, once I have a harbor, I'm going to work on another workboat, I think, to send up to Laffy. I will need 2 workboats soon, actually. I am also tempted to buy this tile right here. Because that is actually a really good tile to work. I'm going to lock that to make sure I always work it. That's 2 food and 6 gold. That is actually pretty darn decent. That's going to earn itself in really quick. So after this, I'm going to queue up another workboat. And then I'm going to build a cargo ship. I think I already have a market. Yes, I do. So that's nice. Warriors and archers. Well, that's not really scary. And then in two turns, I'm going to get my settler. I think I'm actually going to start working on... do I only have two workers left? Huh. Maybe I deleted a tad too many workers. Because now I actually need to work on a road. Unless I just skip the road, and I do want a road, actually. Because I want to be able to send reinforcements down here quickly, should I need to. Though, okay, he's denouncing me. That's not good. I may build the road down south, though. I'm actually not sure. Nah, I think I'm actually going to build it north of the mountains. But yeah, this is... I have a lot of shit to do. I cannot afford to be aggressive right now, which is a little bit annoying, because I'd like to be. But sadly, you can't always do what you want in civilization. Oh, hello. Yeah. Bonus versus gunpowder units. Okay. Why do I have bonus versus gunpowder units? Since when did I get that? What? Combat strength. Plus one movement. What? Discipline. Bonus versus mounted. Why do I have bonus versus gunpowder units? That is a very weird... How did I get that? From honor? Combat bonus versus barbarians. Is there any policies here that increases my... What? Why on earth do I have bonus versus gunpowder units? Is the Ikanda? Is that the one? That could be the Ikanda, actually. In addition to the regular abilities of the barracks, which replaces, the Ikanda grants a unique set of promotions to pre-powder gunpowder melee and is greater within the city. These include faster movement and greater combat strength. Only the Zulu may build it. Seriously, if some of you actually know why I'm getting a bonus versus gunpowder units, then please let me know, because that makes me... I've never seen that before, and I've never heard of anyone actually getting a bonus versus gunpowder units. But it's a pretty significant bonus. I mean, it's a 25% bonus. That is pretty huge. I mean, I theoretically have a higher combat strength than those guys right now. Though they may need a little bit of help. Yeah, that is weird as fuck. Never heard of that before. Alright, we have a great scientist. That's going to be a... that is definitely going to be a... academy. But where? I like to build academies on grasslands. I feel like that's... yep, I'm going to... Isn't this... Yeah, grasslands are good tiles because they offer two food. That's why I like working them, so I'm gonna build it on the spot where the worker... Not where the worker is, but where the settler is. Alright, now what should I get? Probably I should churn out a couple of longswordsmen while I still have them. So I'm gonna build a forge. And then I'm gonna queue up some longswordsmen. 1, 2, 3, 4 longswordsmen. I do believe I have the heroic epic. Yes, I do. So those are going to be 50% stronger, which is really nice. As far as this Attila's court, I am probably going to build up some coliseums. I need happiness in a big way right now. And I should also get these bananas. There we go. Oh my god. They just embarked. I think I'm going to send some Impi down here, just in case those guys decide to come closer. And we'll send these guys down to reinforce Alundi. Alright, harbor's gonna be done soon. So this city is gonna grow like crazy once that happens. I'm already getting 5... Ah, she wants declaration of friendship. That is A-okay with me. Carthage is pretty far away, and she's actually very isolated. But she is the tech leader, and that is kinda scary. She's researched 54% of the tech tree. I'm definitely going to have to spy on her, I think, when I'm done spying on Japan, because Carthage is massive. So is Kyoto, though. And since Carthage is the tech leader, she has a bigger chance of having a counter-spy in her capital. Alright, we can actually grab rationalism now. As much as I want to grab maritime infrastructure, that would be pretty kick-ass. It would help Ungla Bungla Bungla. It would help Laffy. It would help. Oh, it's almost too good not to do. Oh my god. Oh, there's so many good tenants in the exploration tree. I mean, look at that, but still, no, I need the 10% science. It's too important. You can't neglect that. If I do it, I'm gonna fall too far behind. Alright, what do I want right now? Probably some more military tanks. I think I'm gonna have to beeline for industrialization, actually. Yep, that's what I'm gonna need to do. Industrialization and then scientific theory. It's gonna be too important, guys. Alright, let's get some more farms going. And let's start building the road. God, there's a lot of barbarians coming out of this encampment. Holy crap. Alright, start building a road over here. And we're gonna have our academy right here. So it's gonna be worth 8 science and 2 food. That's a really good tile. Lock that to make sure we're always working it, regardless of what kind of production the city is on. You always want to lock tiles like this. Like, if I set my city to production focus, it's not gonna work the academy, and you always want to make sure you work the academy regardless, because it's simply too good of a tile not to work. I mean, 8 science, that is massive. You know, even if I want the city to go all out on production, I still want it to work that tile regardless. Same with the Rock of Gibraltar, simply too good of a tile not to work. But then again, happiness is starting to become a problem again. I also want to check. I got 3 cotton right now, and I'm exporting all of them. That is not good. Why am I exporting all my cotton? I need to make sure I don't renew the cotton trade. Alright. You know, I can actually grind this encampment for a while. I don't really see the point in... Alright, Napoleon has completed a red fort. That is the building which makes defensive structures more powerful. A research agreement, well, she is the leader, but still, that is too good to pass up. You know my opinion on research agreements. You know how important I think they are. So, there's definitely no way I am not building a research agreement. Alright, our harbor is done, so that means we can start trading with Carthage. We probably want a harbor in Lothi as well, but we're going to need to build a workshop first. Which reminds me, I need to get work started on a university there. Marble and sugar, apparently. I have the economy to buy these resources, and I think I will.
Bonjour.
I'm going to spend 9 gold per turn to get myself some sugar. And also, I know for a fact that one of these guys has marble. Well, they have marble, but they don't have marble that they actually want to sell me. So, let's check the cities. We love the King Day. They want copper, sugar, marble, and wine. Okay, copper, sugar, marble, and wine. I do believe I saw someone selling copper. Yep, Sweden is selling copper, but I don't think they like me very much. So I'm not sure if I'm necessarily going to be able to get a good deal here. Nope. I'm not going to go higher than 12 gold per turn. That's as high as I'm going to go. But he wants to give me... resources for 12 gold per turn, so that is completely fine. Alright, now I can take down the encampment, I think. There we go. And we're gonna settle our new city right here. And that might actually make us able to trade with, well, we're gonna need to have to build a unit in order to start trading with Stockholm, but we need to explore to see if Stockholm has any coastal cities. We might be able to trade with Kyoto if this is actually part of the ocean right here. I'm gonna have to check that. I am not sure. Also, I think I'm just gonna get rid of this caravan over here because I want all my trades to be via sea, especially when I have the Colossus, because that does increase the amount of gold you get from trade routes. So I think I wanna... Not sure if the East India Company actually gives you bonus gold for trade routes. I don't think it does. Alright, Tila's court loves the king, and Laffy loves the king. That's what we like to see. That extra growth bonus is always real nice. Alright, so now we're gonna settle our next city. There we go. Let's grab a monument in the city. Wow, this city has decent production. Holy crap. And we want to build a road all the way over here. In fact, once we're done with this farm, we might want to send a worker down here and grab the gems. It's going to give us a lot of extra gems to sell, guys. It's going to give us like 3 extra copies, which is going to be really good for our economy. In hindsight, I realize it might have been a little bit stupid to sign a research agreement with Carthage, considering she is the science leader. Even I think I actually could have asked her for a little bit of extra, because she's a few hours ahead of me for sure, which meant that I could have asked her for some gold. Not sure if she would have complied, but maybe. Alright, Golden Age ended. That is always a sad thing to see. Goodbye, barbarians. Alright, I think there's some more encampments down here that we can hunt. I'm actually really curious. I'm not sure if Sweden has taken Kathmandu. It's not taken any damage yet. But they might. I wonder if I should pledge my protection. Nah, I don't really see the point in having open borders with Daido. Yes, I wanna continue that trade. However, I wanna make sure I don't sell all of my cotton, because that's what I'm currently doing. I'm also selling all of my horses. Now, once I'm done with these cargo ships, I need to build an armory in Unglabunglabunglu, and I need to get some caravels, at least one caravel up and running, so I can start exploring these seas. Ah, nice, I can steal myself a tech. What can I steal? Banking and physics. I think it's going to have to be physics then. Both are worth equally much. I think I'm just going to go for physics then. Alright, we have a caravan. Do I want to sell it yet? I don't think so. I think I want to keep my... I don't know. If I put it up to Attila's court, I might be able to trade with Japan. Maybe. That could work. I mean, at least I'll get a trade route going with Japan, which will give me a little bit of extra science. If not, I think I'll just delete it. I don't know. Depends on how quickly I can get 5 new trade routes going. I think I'm done expanding for now. There is still... Oh my god, that's... Japan, you're getting really feisty right now. A little bit too feisty for my tastes. I think we're just gonna have to go to war and crush these cities, actually. I'm sorry, but that's too much. That is too much. I am... I'm sorry, Japan, but that is too ridiculous. Like, I don't really know what you think that you're going to get out of that, but there's no way I'm going to let these cities stand. So I'm going to take them out before they get dangerous. So I'm going to build myself a little bit of a library over here, and I also want to send these new crossbowmen, send them over here so I can promote them. You can go here into Nobama. You can go up here. Alright, do we want to send our caravan anywhere? Certainly don't want to trade. Now, I'll... What I could do is I could ferry food to Alundi. To help grow it even quicker. I can actually only send production to Alundi. But you know what? Maybe that's a good idea. I'll send some production to Alundi. Yeah, I am going to crush his city. I don't think he has many troops nearby. Right, now I'm working on a cargo ship. That's good. It's going to take me 8 turns. That's quite a long time. I wonder if he's going to ask me. But yeah, this is not acceptable. This right here is definitely not acceptable. He's definitely sending some units to the city. If he asks me right now, I might backstab him. I'm actually not sure. I think I'll just declare war the next turn with the units I currently have. Yeah. Let's move the great general up. Let's declare war on him. I will lose some trades. I will lose the pearls. I'm going to need to buy myself a luxury right now if I want my happiness to stay strong. So I'm gonna buy some incense. Continue. So at least now my empire isn't unhappy anymore. Alright, let's get the... So let's see, these are plains and the city's on a hill. Okay, that's good then. That is actually really good. And these crossbowmen can shoot twice. So that's really good. But yeah, this is ridiculous if he thinks he can get away with this. I don't have my medics here. That is a problem. A trebuchet or two would actually be really nice as well. Fishing boats has been destroyed. Hey! Oh no. That's not good. That is not good. I need to get an armory up and I need to get a caravel going before I can build that cargo ship. Just by the looks of it right now, I'm going to lose all of my fishing boats if this goes on. Alright, well, let's start attacking the city. We can just start to soften it up right away. Let's just fortify. There we go. Are we going for gunpowder? We should. I might be able to steal it from Japan, though, in 21 turns, so that's fine. Okay, the city-state is not at war with me, I hope. Nope, they're not. Good. Here comes another crossbowman with logistics. Have fun, Shaka. But yeah, this fishing boat right here is going to be a big problem. I hope he comes closer so I can start shooting him down. But yeah, I am definitely racing these cities. There is no way I'm going to let them stand. He's probably starting to send samurai towards me now, but these logistic crossbowmen can actually deal with them. Not well, but they can deal with them a little bit. Which is really what all I need right now. I'm wondering if I can actually shoot over the forest if I'm shooting on someone stationed on a hill. I don't think I can, but I'm going to check. Alright, just going to take the city down a little bit. Okay, that got me a great general, so that's good. Alright, awesome, it came closer. I might be able to shoot it down now. Okay, now this guy does not have logistics. Okay, never mind. We're not going to go for gunpowder. We are going to go for industrialization. I'm pretty sure I'll be able to steal gunpowder from Japan. Oh my god! He wants to embargo me? That would be pretty damaging. I'm going to have to vote against that. I really hope that's not going to go true. I really do. I'm not going to sell cotton because I need that. So that should put me back up to normal happiness again. I already had cotton. What? And now suddenly, 3 cotton, 3 exports. What? I don't get it. I really don't. Is it because I've gotten some tiles pillaged? I am actually not sure. Oh my god, the samurai has arrived. The samurai has indeed arrived. Oh crap. Crap. I'm embargoed. That means I can only have trade routes between my own cities. Well, fuck me, that's bad. Yeah, that's really bad. I just got embargoed. Fuck me. Yeah, that's really, really bad. I can still trade with city-states, though. I'm pretty sure I can still trade with city-states. I'm gonna try to repeal the embargo ban. Maybe I can buy Dido's votes. Okay, so now my happiness is not looking very good. So what should Attila's court get? Probably. Is there anything I can do to get happiness? Probably not. I think Attila's court just needs not a granary, that's for sure. Well, if I can't... Do I really want to get caravans? Like, I don't really know. I don't even know. That embargo really hurt me. It really hurt me bad. I think I need a bank. Maybe a forge and a bank. I do have iron. So the forge will speed up my production a little bit. All right, well, let's... how much damage can I do to these guys? I actually have an additional range. That's... No, I can't shoot over the forest. Okay. These guys do not have range. Crap. This is actually really bad. This is really bad. Why do I suddenly have 5 cotton? What the fuck? Okay, how much can I get for that? 200 gold and 5 gold per turn? That's a little bit ambitious. Oh my god. That was actually... She was happy to oblige. Could have asked for more, I think. Yeah, fighting against Japan isn't fun. It's not very fun at all. It is actually very not fun. As you can see right here. These samurais are kind of making my life a living hell right now. I might be able to shoot them down. I'm not sure. I'm gonna try. Well, at least I have some longswordsmen right now. They can get the buffalo chest promotion, so I'm gonna send them up here. They can probably fight against the samurai a little bit. Bam, bam. Okay, good. I killed the samurai. That's good, right? I'm gonna switch the locations of these two guys. Crossbowmen, good units. Very good units. Will be even better when I get them to when I finally get them to be Gatling guns. I think I can still trade with Milan. I'm pretty sure I can. La France. Okay, he wants to buy my cotton. That's completely fine. He can buy my horses too, for all I care. 13 gold per turn. That's decent. I can still have a good economy. I don't really want to buy buildings now, though. But hey, at least the crossbowmen are doing really good work against his samurai. I hope he just doesn't arrive with more of them. That would be kind of bad. Oh, what? Are you fucking kidding me? Did he just kill my crossbowman? Oh no. That's not good. Oh, what's this? Is the city-state attacking me now? Valletta Caraval, that's so far, that's a long way from home. What the fuck are you doing? Well, at least I'll kill this guy. It's gonna take me some time. Probably a few more turns of volleys, but... It will go down. And fuck Japan, that's all I can say. Okay, the road is soon done. We're gonna get some more gems soon. That's good. We're still very unhappy, which I don't like. And that fucking Japanese boat pillaged a lot of our fish, which I also do not like. But hey, what can you do? I do wonder if, okay, ideology, Japan has adopted the autocracy ideology. I am not very surprised. Not very surprised at all. Alright, crossbowmen can now get march. I think that is, actually, no, you know what? If I get range, then I can probably shoot on the city from here. So I'm not gonna do that. Oh, wow. I can get one extra range. That is so kick-ass when I eventually get Gatling guns. Alright. Swordsmen have arrived. Long swordsmen have arrived. They are pretty kick-ass. Alright, road is nearly completed. My god, the city is gonna grow in 303 turns. Yeah, that's the problem with being unhappy. I'm pretty sure these guys can still shoot at Toyama, despite... oh, well. No, my good friend. I'm going to sign a peace treaty with you, but I'm going to milk you a little bit first. Oh my god, more samurai. I'm going to milk you for everything you're worth. Oh my god, are those... No, those are mine. Those are Zulu long swordsmen. I'm going to have to shoot down the samurai, though, I think. I'm pretty sure. Or maybe not. What? How can I not attack those guys? What? Kaboom. Can I take the city now? No, not yet. Alright, let's choose a host. I'm going to make Dido the host. I have the power to make her the host. And I would prefer her over Gustav, that's for sure. Alright, more longswordsmen with buffalo loins and all that good shit. Go away! Okay, I'm gonna get my caravel in 4 turns. That's very good news. And I'm gonna get 2 more iron too, so I can actually... so I can get even more longswordsmen that I can use to promote. I don't think the promotion from longswordsmen to musketmen is a very expensive one. He wants to sell me iron. Not really. He doesn't like me a lot right now. Actually, he actually doesn't hate me that much. He just signed a really good deal with me. That's a little bit surprising, actually. More. Here comes the crossbowmen. The big question is, can I take Tomaya on this turn? I might be able to. We'll have to see. I might be able to. There we go. I am just gonna race it. We need to be careful with these Impi. Actually, we don't. Come to think of it. Because the city can't kill us anymore. However, we are going to burn it down. Alright, we should probably grab a courthouse. Oh my god, our happiness is not looking very good right now. It's looking pretty fucking awful. We need to buy some luxuries. What can we get right now? Nothing, it would appear. Nope, not a damn thing. So I'm going to try to take ice, which I don't think is going to work out. But if it does... I might be able to get a peace treaty with Japan. He's a stubborn fucker, though. He's real stubborn. He might... I don't think he's going to be able to take Tomaya with these. He's going to try. Yeah, now she's very happy with me because I just gave her the World Congress leadership. Which is nice because I might be able to buy her votes. But I would need to relocate my spy first. Which I can't do until 14 turns. But that's fine because the next World Congress is not going to... happen until 27 turns anyway. Yeah, he's trying to take it back, but it's not really working out for him. I'm gonna try to kill those samurai. I'm pretty sure the city will burn down right now. Yep. Okay, now I demand citrus. That's pretty cool. There we go. Down goes the samurai. And here comes the longswordsmen, and they're pretty badass. In fact, they are super badass. They got buffalo join. No, buffalo joints. Buffalo loins, not joints. Okay, let's talk to Japan. Let's see if he's actually interested in talking. We're eagerly anticipating your unconditional surrender. Oh, he still thinks he's got an edge on me. Well, little does he know that I have crossbowmen with 1+1 range, which means I can siege him. Okay, she wants to go to war with Napoleon, no? I would actually like Napoleon to go to war against Japan. I'm going to speak to him and see if he's interested. I would be really happy if Napoleon were to declare war on Japan. Who actually has the strongest military in this game? I think it's Japan. No, it's Daido. Oh my god, she has a really fucking strong army. It's over twice as large as mine. Not necessarily large, but... at least it's twice as powerful as mine. Alright, we got the longswordsmen. Let's send them back to heal. Can we get vision from here? No, we cannot. However, we can start bombarding the city. I just want to heal up a little bit first. These crossbowmen, I actually kind of regret not taking march on them, but I guess it will have to do for now. Still struggling a little bit with the happiness. I can't see any of Japan's troops around here, though. I'm gonna get a minor warmonger penalty if I take this city. That's fine. I can deal with minor penalties. It's the major ones I'm worried about. Enemy unit has been sighted in my territory. More Japanese ships. Yes, actually. Oh, hello. Those are Japanese caravels. That's not good. Definitely don't like that. I'm gonna bring my crossbowmen over. I might buy some more crossbowmen once these guys are done. I think I'll need some. I'm getting a pretty hefty combat penalty right now, though. I definitely don't like that. Alright, move these guys back a little bit. They heal twice as fast in friendly territory. Alright. Yeah, definitely don't like the fact that Nobama is under attack right now. Caravels are a little bit scary. I might have to buy walls in Nobama. Especially if he brings heavier ships to the fray, which he might. We'll have to see. Maybe he'll be able to sign it. Maybe he'll be willing to talk. I have killed one of his cities. I don't know. Those are Galleasses, and that's Gatling guns. Alright, I am gonna see if he's interested in talking right now. Shit. Yeah, I'm gonna ask him. He might be able to talk. Fine. Why did that suddenly decrease my happiness? Alright, we need to buy some luxuries. Wait, what did I give him stuff right now? I didn't give him anything, did I? I didn't quite see the odd. Oh no. People are barbarians are ruining my shits. All right. Well, at least I can get vision, which means that these caravels are basically gonna look how far this guy can see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He has a vision of 5, which is pretty ridiculous. Alright, we need another academy. I'm gonna get one. Where is it? Grassland. I like to build academies on grasslands if I can help it, but it doesn't look like I have any more grassland tiles. So I'm just gonna build it on a plane. Alright. Oh, it was fun while it lasted, that's for sure. So let's send some crossbowmen, just, you know, in case Japan gets some silly ideas. I definitely had to end the war once I saw he had Gatling guns, you know, at that point I... at that point I really needed to strike a deal. Okay, I can buy it for flood gold though. How much? 250?
Yeah.
That's okay. And... I can buy from Sweden, but I don't think I have enough gold per turn. Maybe he values horses? No. I really need to get this embargo away from me. I really do. This embargo is really hurting me in many ways. Also, I think I can... he wants open borders? No. Wow, this guy's economy is not good. I don't think I need any more crossbowmen right now. I'll build this one. And then I'll stop. Because right now I need to work on my economy. Seriously, fuck this embargo. Like, really fuck this embargo. That really hurt me so bad. Oh my god, look how much this caravel is exploring. Jesus Christ. Alright, now I really need to get these guys away from here. Also, once I'm done with this farm, I need to go down and repair. Because I'm losing a lot from those gems. Alright. I want these swordsmen down here, actually. I do believe I have a garrison everywhere. Well, I'm about to have one here. I need to have a garrison in every single city. I don't, actually. Let's send them over here. It's important you always have a garrison whenever you play Honor. Also, this city needs to grow. Doesn't it have a single tile it can work that actually gives it food? That should really be better. At least it's going to grow soon. Alright, let's get ourselves another academy. As I said, we need to do whatever we can to get as much science as possible. Yeah, I'm actually, you know what, maybe I should just reassign. Napoleon is plotting against me. Out of all people who could be plotting against me, it's fucking Napoleon. Like... Japan hates me, Sweden hates me, But Napoleon is plotting against me. Seems legit. The more I'm thinking about it, the more... I really need to grow this city, or else this Colosseum is only going to be worth one happiness. You can only get as much happiness from a Colosseum as there are citizens in the city. So if you have a one-pop city, then you can't... You can't... This Colosseum won't be very effective, so to say. Right, finish this farm. We need to get over here and repair those tiles. Damn, that musketman did a lot of damage. Where did he even come from? There's like no encampments anywhere near here that I can see, and I am able to see them all. So that was really strange. Alright, at any rate, I think I'm going to end this turn, and then I'm going to end this part. Whew, this is a tough game. I'm definitely having some mixed feeling about it. It's not going very well, to be quite honest. Like, I am so far behind in tech right now. I'm catching up, though. I'm at 42% right now. So I am definitely catching up. It's going to be a pretty hard climb to be able to get back. These two academies that I've gotten and the rationalism opener definitely helps, although I'm not getting any benefit out of that right now because my empire is very unhappy. But once I solve my unhappiness issue, and I need to get this embargo away from me. You found it very troubling that I want to unembargo myself? Seriously, dude? Are you serious right now? Wow. Well, Japan is Japan, and they will always be Japan. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, hope you guys enjoyed this patch. At least we got rid of the city. That's something, right? In fact, I think what I want to do is I want to have an Impi over here to scout, to see if Japan is going to be up to no good, and if they're going to start making trouble in my neighborhood. I also think I want an Impi over here. Alright, I'll see you next time, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye.